Welcome to Electromagnetics playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain Coulomb's law. So first of all, I'll explain you what is Coulomb's law. Then I'll explain you the direction of force which is acting on charges as per calculation by Coulomb's law. Then we will see the direction of forces which is happening on charges as per Coulomb's law. And at the end, I'll explain one example based on Coulomb's law. So see, first of all, what is Coulomb's law? So see, Coulomb's law explains force acting in between two charges. And force acting in between two charges, that is directly proportional to their charges and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So let me write it. So force acting in between two charges, that is directly proportional to those two charges and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. So for example, if I consider two charge particles, let us say one charge is Q1 and second charge is Q2. And if distance between these two charge, that is if it is R, then force acting in between two charge particle, force acting in between these two charge particle, that force is directly proportional to these two charge Q1 and Q2 and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. And this proportionality constant, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, and this is Q1 Q2 divided by R square. So this is Coulomb's law. So force acting in between two charge particle, that is directly proportional to those two charges and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. Now I'll explain you two cases where what will happen if polarity of two charges are same, and second case will be what will happen as if polarity of these two charges are opposite. So let us consider first case. So in first case, case number one, I'll consider both charges are having same polarity. So if both charges are having same polarity, like if both are positive, then Q1, Q2 multiplication, that will be greater than zero. Or if both charges are negative, in that case even Q1, Q2 multiplication will be greater than zero. So in that case, if you observe, these are the two charges Q1 and Q2, and distance between these two, if I say it is R, then force will be repulsive force. So you'll be finding repulsive force that will happen on both of these charges. If polarity of both of the charges, that is same, in that case, there will be repulsive force that will act on these two charges. Now let us consider second case. So in second case, if I say both charges are having unlike polarity, like one charge is positive and second charge is negative. So in that case, Q1, Q2, that will be less than zero. So in this case, there will be attractive force. So these two charges Q1 and Q2, see, both are apparted by distance R. So there will be attractive force that will happen in between these two charges. And force acting on both of the charges will be same. And you can see the direction of force, right? So if charges are having like polarity, then there will be repulsive force. And if charges are having unlike polarity, in that case, there will be attractive force which will happen on these two charges. Now, let us try to understand this with respect to direction, so it will be more clear. So now I'll show you this calculation by direction. So see, if I say we have two charges, let us say this charge is Q1, this charge is Q2, and Q1, that is indicated by position vector R1, and this charge Q2, that is indicated by position vector R2. And here If I say Q1 and Q2 both are having same polarity, in that case there will be repulsive force. So you'll be finding if both are, here I'm considering this case, Q1, Q2 is greater than 0. So for this case, there will be repulsive force. So this force will be repulsive force. Now how to calculate this repulsive force? By direction. So for that, see the basic formula, that is force, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 Q2 by R square. Now you just see, as both of these charges are having like polarity, there will be repulsive force. So on Q1 force is happening in this direction, and on Q2 force is happening on this direction. So if I say I want to calculate force acting on charge Q1, let us say that is F1 by direction, and force acting on charge Q2, let us say that is F2 by direction, right? Magnitude is same, but direction is opposite, right? So how to calculate force F1? So let us say this force F1, that is there in this direction, so we need to multiply position vector, unit position vector R1, right? Unit position vector R1. Now what is this unit position vector R1 for a calculation of force acting on this charge Q1? So for that calculation, see, position, unit position vector R1, that is vector R divided by magnitude of vector R. So see, vector R, that is there in this direction. So we need to consider direction by head minus tail. So head, that is Q1, and tail, that is Q2. So Q1 is associated, with position vector R1, and Q2, that is associated with position vector R2. So direction on force acting on this, that is R1 minus R2. So here you need to consider this direction R1 minus R2, and divide by magnitude, that is R only, right? So see, now if you place this formula over here, so now this formula will get to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square into vector R divided by magnitude of vector R. So now by direction, this force, now that will change to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R cube into vector R, where vector R is R1 minus R2 in case of you calculate force acting on charge Q1. And similarly, we can have a calculation of direction for force acting on charge Q2, and that will be, if I say that magnitude will be same, but you will be finding that direction is opposite. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R cube, but now you will be finding direction is vector R will be now vector R2 minus vector R1, and that is happening as per head minus tail, where head is actually this, means R2 minus R1. See, that is how it is happening. Now why I am explaining this, the reason is I have seen students were asking one question always, like, see, in books sometimes that is written as per formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 Q2 by R cube into vector R. See, actual force is Q1 Q2 by R square. Sometimes in books you will be finding 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, that is written as K. So K Q1 Q2 by R square. And in some formulas you will be finding it is K Q1 Q2 by R cube into vector R. So that is happening as per unit vector. Why? The reason is, see, this is direction vector. This is direction vector. So direction vector is direction divided by magnitude of it. So that will get to unit vector. That's why this formula is getting changed by 1 divided by R cube instead of R square. So this is what you need to keep in your mind. Sometimes you'll be finding it is written as per R, 1 by R cube, right? But that R cube is happening because of unit vector. So this is what we need to consider when we calculate examples. Now let us try to solve one problem so it will be more clear. So here we have been given with one question, and that question is, we have two charges. One charge is Q1, and that is 1 microcoulomb, and second charge is Q2, that is 2 microcoulomb, and both are apparted by distance 1 meter. So what is the force which is acting on Q1? So first of all, we need to understand one thing. See here, this Q1 and Q2 both are having same polarity. So as both are having same polarity, this force will be repulsive force. So on Q1 as well as Q2, force will be repulsive force as polarity of both charges are same. And here position vector is not given. So as if position vector is not given, we can only calculate magnitude. If position vector is been given, in that case, you can find position vector as per I have explained here. So this force calculation, that will be F is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. This is a magnitude. And this will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 altogether, that is 9 into 10 to the power 9 in SI. And Q1, that is 1 microcoulomb, so 10 to the power minus 6. Q2, that is 2 microcoulomb, so 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 divided by R square. R square is 1 meter, so I'm writing 1 square. So if you calculate this, 9 into 2, that is 18 into 10 to the power 9 and 10 to the power minus 6, minus 6. So 9 minus 6 minus 6, that will be 10 to the power minus 3. So this much amount of Newton force that is acting on both of these charges. Now here, one thing that we need to keep in our mind, sometimes there will be direction which will be given to you. So direction that you need to identify based on position vectors, and position vector that you need to calculate as per head minus tail. And remember one thing, in direction you will have to take Q1 Q2 by R cube as R2 minus R1, that direction that you are multiplying it to show in that direction force is acting. So this is what we need to keep in our mind while we calculate examples based on Coulomb's law. I hope that you have understood this. So in future, I'll show you some examples even. So that will give you clear idea like how to calculate some typical problems. But here I'm just showing you how to calculate examples based on Coulomb's law and what is Coulomb's law. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos which will solve all those queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.